What's good, Sip? Today I'm back with another video. Today I'm going to talk about Hassan Whiteside. As some rumors have been going around lately about him potentially being traded to Los Angeles Lakers. Of course, Hassan Whiteside did sign a minimum contract with the Sacramento Kings this past offseason, and he's been having a pretty solid season for the Kings, and a very underrated one as well, as he's averaging about 9 points per game and a block, and not too many minutes off the bench. And he's doing his thing, man. I think a lot of contender teams could definitely use a guy like Hassan Whiteside, because the Sacramento Kings, he doesn't fit in that system, because he's around like 27 years old right now, and he's not going to be part of their future. He's probably there just for their mentorship and veteranship, like Luke Walton said. He's just there, you know, to bring some experience to the team, but he could definitely be on another team. With that in mind, the Los Angeles Lakers are very interested in acquiring Hassan Whiteside in either the buyout market or in the trade deadline, according to ESPN reports. And of course, like I said, Hassan Whiteside, he's a very interesting player, man, because a lot of people have two perspectives on Hassan Whiteside. One is that he's a very lazy player, a guy that, you know, he's a very overrated defender that just gets bullied in the paint, and just a guy that's not going to do anything for a contender. But there's the other perspective of Hassan Whiteside, which is the one that, you know, averages 2 blocks per game, the guy that's focused, a guy that will just do his role like he did with the Portland Trail Blazers last season, and just a guy that's going to fix a lot of Lakers' problems right now, which is the perspective I agree with the most. Because the other perspective was mainly Hassan Whiteside, you know, in the Miami Heat, all that drama that happened over there. I think he's mature enough right now, you know, to know that if he's going to join a contender like the Lakers, he's going to be focused, man. He has to be focused, and I'm sure he's going to do whatever he can, you know, to join that team and do his role, that is, you know, block shots and just defend the paint and obviously catch those loss from LeBron James. So yeah, Hassan Whiteside on the Lakers right now is a perfect target for the team, because that's the player they need right now, man. That's the only player they should definitely, you know, just target, honestly, because the other positions are pretty much set. Maybe if you want to get a wing defender that's available, I don't know which one's available, because the only one I can think of at the top of my head is Iman Shumpert, and he signed with the Brooklyn Nets, so I don't have too many ideas on that. But for the big man situation, man, they definitely need another big man, because Marc Gasol, he can't move in the paint, man. That guy just gets bullied. He's just too old, man. I know the purpose of the Lakers trading for Marc Gasol was obviously, you know, because of the experience that he has, you know, in the NBA, a veteran guy that knows a lot about winning, you know, with the FIBA and all that, and just a guy that knows a lot about the game of basketball. Of course, a guy that has good chemistry with LeBron James, and a guy that was there, obviously, you know, to teach Anthony Davis and get him better, but that hasn't been the case yet. He hasn't been even efficient either in the offensive end. He's been pretty inefficient, and a guy that just... He's just not doing his role properly, and that's because of his age, like I said. And the thing is that there's no other options, because the other big man that they have is Montrezl Harrell, which they signed instead of signing Dwight Howard back, which was a huge mistake, honestly. And with the Sacramento Kings expressing in the past that they might be willing to buy out Hassan Whiteside, the Lakers are definitely interested. If we're talking about Hassan Whiteside and the Lakers, I think Hassan Whiteside will definitely bring a boost, obviously, in the big man position. And just a guy that's going to do his role, of course, block shots, catch those alley-oops from LeBron James and Dennis Schroeder, and, you know, just play his role efficiently, man. Just a guy that's going to be there and just provide all he can to win a championship, because I know Hassan Whiteside wants to be on a better team. That's not the Sacramento Kings, because he barely got any offers this past offseason, and that's mainly because other teams, you know, didn't need him right now. But with how things are going with the Lakers, this might be the perfect target, man. And obviously a buyout will have to happen, of course, for this to happen. But if a trade were to happen, which might happen as well, it doesn't have to be that much. Obviously it will have to be like a second round pick, and maybe trade like a player, like maybe, I don't know, maybe trade like Talon Horton Tucker and a pick for Hassan Whiteside. I wouldn't do it, honestly, but they're probably gonna ask for like a jump player and a second round pick for Hassan Whiteside, which will be a pretty good move for the Kings if they want to do that. But for the Lakers, I wouldn't trade anyone. Just trade a second round pick for Hassan Whiteside, because it's not worth it, you know, trading a young guy like Talon Horton Tucker for Hassan Whiteside, who might be a 1-year rental. So we'll have to wait and see. Hassan Whiteside right now is targeted by the Lakers. He's been playing pretty good this season, like I said, and will definitely be a boost, man. I would definitely try to consider signing this guy or trading for him, I guess, you know, second round pick for, in the trade deadline, which is coming up very soon, man. A lot of rumors are going on lately, and I'm really excited to see what's going to happen, because, you know, the NBA is unpredictable, man. Anything can happen. Hassan Whiteside could sign with the Los Angeles Lakers or the Brooklyn Nets, man. These are the two teams that definitely need a big man right now. And not only a big man, but a guy that can defend the paint and a guy that can catch those lobs at a very high efficient rate. So yeah, man, let me know in the comments what you guys think. Do you think Hassan Whiteside will actually sign with the Los Angeles Lakers? Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like, subscribe for new, and click the bell to get notified on my official videos. I hope you have a great day. Peace out.